And now, the WWF Rewind, presented by SmackDown 2. Break out the tables, ladders, or chairs and lay the SmackDown. In WWF SmackDown 2, Know Your Role for the PlayStation game console.
Oh my God, it's the Acolyte! Oh no, they're back! TNA, shut the APA down for a while! Oh my God, the clothesline from hell! My Bradshaw! APA, back in business!
The return of the Acolytes last Sunday at Armageddon. We're not too pleased that TNA had taken over the APA offices after Kess and Albert put the Acolytes out a few months ago with some serious injuries.
Well, you knew once the real...
Making his way to the ring, being accompanied by Trish, Stratus, and Albert. He weighs in at 282 pounds.
Well, we're about 6 weeks away, Taz, from the start of the XFL season. Everyone's talking about it, including the weekend edition of the USA Today. I cannot believe 6 weeks away from the start of the XFL and the New York, New Jersey Hitmen right here in the New York City area.
I'm going to be a big fan of the New York, New Jersey Hitmen. I can tell you that. And the XFL will make a real impact on professional football.
Speaking of impact, here come Faarooq and Bradshaw.
Being accompanied to the ring by Faarooq, he weighs in at 302 pounds.
What's the deal with these damn ring announcers always just interrupting us? I don't like to interrupt me. They even interrupt you, and you're supposed to be good at this.
Here we go. Jeff wastes a little time going to work on Bradshaw in this one-on-one matchup. I'll tell you, the Acolytes not too pleased with the fact that TNA took over the APA offices. You know, Kess and Albert put Bradshaw and Faarooq out with serious injuries, including rib injuries and a knee injury to Faarooq as well. And the Acolytes had put Crash in charge of their offices, but TNA took it upon themselves to take over and rename it the TNAPA.
APA, you do not want to upset these men. And it seems like TNA kind of upset APA, which, you know, once the APA came back, boom, nice back suplex. Once they came back, they're going to get in the face of TNA. Here we have it.
I get it. You're like a teacher in school. Alphabet soup here as Bradshaw whipped off the ropes, and what a right hand to the back of Test, and what a shot. Dudley boys are in the house for Sunday Night Heat. We are in the holiday season, just about 8 days away from Christmas here in New York City, Taz, and Dudley boys, the special guest host on Heat, having all kinds of problems with Santa Claus. But I'm curious, you guys ever go door to door and go Christmas caroling in Red Hook, Brooklyn?
Well, we don't know about Christmas caroling, but we do go out and, you know, we do go out and sing songs, yeah.
Well, that's what I was getting at. But anyhow, what are some of these songs that you guys sing?
Oh, Michael Coleslaw, we got a lot of songs. We got Silent Night, Thug Light Night. You know, we got Joy to the Hook, you know. Joy to the Hook, Taz, he can cook, you know, that kind of stuff.
That's great.
Then we got the world famous Walking in the Brooklyn Neighborhood.
And Walking in the Brooklyn Neighborhood, are you going to sing it for me, or am I just going to guess?
Yeah, well, I'm glad you're kind of out there with that. He's getting his breath, getting his face stomped in. Well, here we go. Walking in the Brooklyn Neighborhood. Police sirens ring, are you listening? In the street, bums are sweeping. The rats are all dead, I found a pigeon head. Walking in a Brooklyn neighborhood.
That's great, Taz. That's great.
You look like a pigeon.
Yeah, look at Taz hammering away on Bradshaw with the big right hands, and Bradshaw is in all kinds of trouble. Thanks to Albert and also a Trish Stratus looking on at ringside.
He's doing a lot of laughing. Seems like Bradshaw ain't doing much laughing. Big old Tess is in his grill.
Oh, I tell you, who isn't doing much laughing, and it hasn't been a good holiday season thus far in the McMahon household up there in Greenwich, Connecticut. Mr. McMahon demanding a divorce from his wife, Linda. Linda's been sent to the hospital. Mr. McMahon berating. Oh, what a low blow from Tess to Bradshaw and plants him with a DDT. Floats into the cover now. Hook of the leg. There's one. There's two. Did he get it? No. Bradshaw got the shoulder up before a count of three.
The McMahon household. I'm glad I'm not in there right now. Mr. McMahon, Vince McMahon himself, he's in like another world, man. I don't know. He's in a zone. I don't know what's up with that.
Test with a cover. He's in a zone as well. There's two, and again, Bradshaw with his shoulder up. Test and Albert have been doing a number on Bradshaw in this matchup.
I still can't get over the look on Mr. McMahon's face in that mirror on SmackDown.
Oh, swinging neck breaker.
I still can't get over it. The laugh, the smirk. I mean, was he getting enjoyment out of that?
Cover by Bradshaw and Test, who slides out after a count of one. Test, I'm sure tomorrow night, live on Raw is War, 9 o'clock, 8 central on TNN. Hopefully, we'll have an update on the medical condition of Linda McMahon, who was rushed to the hospital Thursday on SmackDown. We didn't get any updates this weekend. McMahon, a very private family, and no updates on the condition of Linda McMahon this past weekend.
And who in the hell in their right mind's going to ask any of the McMahons what's going on? I'm sure I ain't going to do that.
Well, Mr. McMahon has blown up at everybody in recent weeks. And
Tets can't even stand up.
Still can't believe, still cannot get over the way that Mr. McMahon treated his daughter, Stephanie, this past Thursday night on SmackDown. Look at Albert. Referee never saw Albert pull Bradshaw out of the ring. And here comes Faarooq. Faarooq getting involved now.
Big Faarooq laying some level on big old Prince's head. This is unreal. Look at this.
A Trish sliding a steel chair into the ring, and Tess. Tess with chair in hand. Oh! The skull, damn, the cranium of Bradshaw. Here's the cover. Referee Tim White had been distracted, and Tess picked up the victory.
Bradshaw is probably one of the toughest men in the World Wrestling Federation. Shut up, ring announcer. But I'll tell you what, ain't no one getting up after a chair shot like that.
Well, before you yelled at the ring announcer, I was going to say you've actually been in a great mood, in the holiday spirit.
Check.